research group focuses on how we could potentially use actual living organic materials in robotic systems. For example, using muscle as an actuator or neurons as controllers, and trying to use these components to build biodegradable and biocompatible biohybrid and organic robots. On one hand, we study existing living organisms. In our lab, we work a lot with sea slugs to study how they move and how they're able to adapt to changes in their environment. And then we also look at what existing living materials we could then harvest from the animal to use directly on the robots. So for example, you might be able to create a robot for applications in environmental monitoring, search and rescue, and even potentially agriculture. And because the robot is made out of these organic materials native to the environment, if it interacts with other organisms in the environment, breaks down, or reaches the end of its mission, then it can naturally degrade as part of the environment. And so we're trying to create really more environmentally friendly robots. And so a big challenge moving them beyond the research lab will be the development of packaging and essentially skins that are able to house these living materials and protect them from the environment. Our goal isn't to recreate fully functioning organisms, but rather to identify and isolate specific capabilities that we can integrate into robotic systems in a sustainable and renewable way. And in doing so, we can really create these biocompatible robots that can be deployed in areas where we have critical need for such robotic systems. For example, in environmental monitoring in coral reefs, where we may not want to deploy robots that are made of metals and plastics and may damage the environment. Or applications in search and rescue, where you may not be able to recover all of your robots at the end of the mission, and so you want them to be able to degrade naturally rather than leaving additional contaminants in the environment. In addition to the broader impacts with regards to developing these types of biohybrid technologies, I think the field of biohybrid robotics is really giving us a very unique opportunity to attract interest from students in traditionally underrepresented populations. What we're seeing is that the biohybrid robots are really able to attract a larger percentage of women. We have a number of Latinx students and even a number of first-generation college students who are participating as volunteers in our research group. And this, I think, is really because biology is much more accessible. It's part of the K-12 curriculum that all of these students have experienced. And so by combining these biology components that are accessible and familiar with the robotics, biohybrid robotics can really serve as a gateway for these students into robotics at large.